Yes, guys. So now we'll take up that fuel consumption data. Okay, I have that in my path here. So we'll look into that data completely. We'll get into the analyzing the data so that we can get some insights from data. So this basically, this technique is called as exploratory data analysis. It is called as exploratory data analysis. Okay, so this particularly is a initial stage of it will be done. Okay, so this step will be done, okay, in the beginning stage, beginning stage of the project cycle. Okay, so any case of my ML based project you are doing it, so you will be doing it with the help of exploratory data analysis, so that you can understand the, so here we can check data types, okay, quantity of the data, okay, apart from that we can visualize the data, understand relationship between the data columns. Okay, so what are the things you can do it? You can visualize it, you can understand the relationship between the data columns. So with this understanding, like example, understand the relation between data, okay, so find out, we can check also the outliers presence in the data. See, based upon that inference, okay, based on this info, we can further decide what action has to be made on the data. Okay, let's take these points now. Hello. Hello. Haan heli. Model year indicates the year of manufacture. Make, this column indicates the which company the car has been produced, in that which model, in that which model you have some variation within the model itself. Okay. So even there is one more column called as hybrid is also present. So then vehicle class, whether it is a compact, SUV, small, that is clearly visible. Engine size, cylinders, transmission, fuel type, okay, what fuel type is used, and a description about that, I have given it here, fuel type description. And in the transmission, you have these variations with a specific number of gears, automatic, automated, manual, okay, automatic with select shift, automatic with continuously variable, okay, automatic, and manual system. Okay, so those are the variations available in the transmission. Fuel type, then fuel consumption in city. Okay, so it is measured per 100 kilometers. Okay, so how many liters of fuel is required. Okay, so type of fuel use and then consumption of the fuel. Okay, for every liter per 100 kilometer, 9.9 liter per 100 kilometer. 11.2 liter per 100 kilometer. So that's what the fuel consumption is required. Okay, so then fuel consumption city and fuel consumption in highway. Okay, in highway we can see that the fuel consumption is decreased. That's what happens, right? Shashank. Raghavendra Venkat. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Raghavendra. Do you drive car?
No, sir. I drive bike.
Okay. ನಿಮಗೆ ಮೈಲೇಜ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡ್ತೀರಿ, ಸಿಟಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕೊಡುತ್ತಾ ಅಥವಾ ಹೈವೇಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕೊಡುತ್ತಾ? ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ
ಹೈವೇಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್.
ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮಿಂಗ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ನೀವು ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಯಾವ ಥರ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ, ಪರ್ ಲೀಟರ್ಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಥರ ಇದೆ ಡೇಟಾ, ಪರ್ 100 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್
ಹೌ ಮಚ್
ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಪರ್ 100 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಕಾರ್ ಯಾರು ಡ್ರೈವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಇಲ್ಲಿ? ಪ್ರೀತಮ್ ಡ್ರೈವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಕಾರ್ನ?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ವಿ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಇಟ್, ಮೈಲೇಜ್ ಪರ್ ಲೀಟರ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್, ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್. ಲೈಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್. ಲೈಕ್ ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆನಿ ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್ ಇಟ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಸನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ so it is taking 9.9 liters per 100 kilometer in the city and it is drastically decreasing 6.7 kilometer, okay, liters. And then fuel consumption combined, what is this fuel consumption combined? So fuel consumption combined is combination of city and highway. Okay, fuel consumption combined is 55% in the city and 45% in the highway. The car is been driven, okay, 55% in the city. That means 55 kilometer in city and 45 kilometer in the highway. So when it is driven, what is the fuel it is consuming? Okay, how much fuel it is consuming? Okay, so that is it is giving us. Okay, so next 1 minute. So then it is given in terms of miles per gallon. Okay, how many miles it will give us for a 1 gallon of fuel? Okay, 33 miles, 29 miles. Like in our case, how do we measure, right? Per liter, how many kilometers it gives, and this is actually giving us the details on like miles, in terms of miles per gallon of fuel. Okay, not in terms of liter, it is in terms of gallon. So what is 1 gallon is equal to how many liters? Any idea? So it is approximately 4 liters. Okay, so to be precise, it is 3.8 liters. Okay, 33 kilometer mileage for 3.8 liters of the petrol or a diesel or a gasoline. Okay, whatever it is, premium gasoline, something like that. Okay, so like this is the information what we have it now, as of now, right? So let's mark it as a cell. We'll move on to the next. So now we'll start the data analysis. Okay, before that I'll just tell you the last column. What is this? Carbon dioxide emission. Finally we have the emission here. So this is the how much carbon dioxide it is actually producing each vehicle. So like now our task is, or the ultimate goal finally is to check which car produces the carbon dioxide. Okay, if I give this kind of information, I should be able to predict the carbon dioxide emission of that particular car, and I should see before that what is the relationship about these entities with in predicting the carbon dioxide emission. First I'll check that. Later on in the next week, okay, that is, we will have a regression analysis, we'll do it and we'll decide like which are the variables which has the influence in predicting the carbon dioxide, and we'll try to build a model. Okay, so before that, so we'll use this day like information and we'll visualize the data. Okay, first, what is the first thing which we'll use it to get the details and the information? How to get the information? Data dot info. Okay, so that gives me the information about my data. Okay, sorry. All right, so how many rows, columns, all information is available. Okay, so then data dot shape, in case you would like to see the shape, 1067 rows and 13 columns. Okay, now I want to check, is there any null values in the data set? I want to check, is there any null value? So check for null values. Okay, so how to check that one? Data, this I not covered it, please now make a note of this. It gives any null values, okay, in this all steps. Okay, wherever null values are there, those information will become true. Okay, so now I can get the sum of that information. Okay, data dot is null, I'm checking, is there any null values in the data frame, and I get the summation of that, sum of that values, like sum of the null values I'm going to print it. Okay, so in model year column there is no null values, make no null values, that means this data as a whole doesn't hold any null values. This data doesn't have any null values. So what we will do if there is a null value? Navya Bhandari. Okay, Meghana KU. Meghana, tell me what you will do if you find there are null values. Null values idre yen martira?
Adana delete martira.
Delete martira athwa bere enadru madbeka?
Replace madodakke.
Replace madbodalva? So either using mean method, depending on the data type, we will use it. Okay, thank you Meghana. So what we have to do is, by looking at this, now we can decide on whether to apply the data pre-processing, like whether we need to apply mean method or mode method, so that we can decide it. Okay. So now we have decided, looking at this information, that we don't require to do anything. Okay. Next, like we'll check now, is there any duplicated values are there? Okay. Duplicate rows are present. Okay. So check for duplicate values. How do we check it? Data dot duplicated dot sum of that, you can get it. One minute. First get this info. Undo. So there is no duplicate rows, there are no duplicate. So this is again will give us the result true or false for each and every row. If there are two rows which are very much similar, so it gives us the information whether duplicate is present or not present. Okay, so now I am getting sum of that values, so total, so there is no duplicated values. So what we have to do it, okay, if there are any duplicated values, if in case duplicate values are present, we can drop them. like duplicate values are not required, right? So we can drop them. How do you drop it? Data is equal to data dot drop dot duplicated duplicates. Okay. So this is how you can do it. Then you can print your data frame. And then print your data and print the data dot info. So the information might have get changed. Okay. Before that information, I'm printing it dot info 1067 entries. Okay, this is drop underscore duplicates. Sorry. You can see here I got no changes. Let me pause printing it. I got same description. That means there, since already we know that there are no duplicates, so we even if you apply this method, even if you apply method, it doesn't have any effect because there are no duplicate values in my current data. If there are duplicate datas are there, then you could see changes in the original information and the then updated data. Okay. So now we can get descriptive statistical information from describe method in pandas. Okay, so let us do that. Data dot describe. It gives us the each column. Okay, it provides statistical info of numerical columns. It gives us the only the information about the numerical columns. It doesn't provide any information about the categorical data or a object type of data in your data frame. Okay, so these are object type of data, so like make, model, vehicle class or objects. So it is not providing any information about them. It is only providing the numerical columns information. What are the information it provides us? It gives us the count of that values in each row of the each column. Then mean value, I need not to calculate, already it has given. Mean, minimum, standard deviation, 25th, that is quartile 1, quartile 2, quartile 3, and then the maximum value. Quartile 3 is what? So it's a maximum value, right? So but in model year you don't find any difference, but you can check the difference in number of cylinders, fuel consumption. Okay, so what is the average? The average fuel consumption is 12.6, sorry, median value is 12.6 and mean value is actually 13.29. so both are very close to each other, that we can say on an average 13 kilometers is the 13 liters is the fuel consumption, okay, per 100 kilometers. Okay, so in highway it is 9 and 8.8. okay, so almost approximately 9 liters is the consumption made. And an average, what is the mileage it is giving per gallon of gasoline? Per 21 and 26, maybe around, around 26 it is giving. That is actually your median value. Okay, 26 and this is also 26. Okay, combinedly it is giving 26 miles per gallon consumption. So like this, it gives you the complete statistical information, the describe method. And we can get this information by box plot also, right? So I'll be using those plots and all in a while. Just clear all my outputs. If you guys not tried, please try all these things.
See if you have done, please let me know.